Hi, my name is Patrick Boyle. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is on the topic of volatility swaps. I'm back to my usual video format today, which is of shorter videos quickly explaining financial topics. I aim to keep them 5 to 10 minutes long with no filler material in them. Last week I posted a series of 6 longer slideshow style lectures. Each one was about an hour long that I put together as a playlist. I think it's called Revision Lectures. A few people had emailed me asking for longer lectures. They basically felt it was easier for them to study that way. So I put those ones together, as revision aids for students who are preparing, we'll say, for an exam or something like that. Let me know what you think of those videos and of these videos. Tell me which style you prefer, because obviously the more feedback I get, the better I can make these videos. And my goal is, of course, for you guys to find them as helpful as possible. Anyhow, on to today's topic, which is volatility swaps. If you want to have a long position in future realized volatility, or to be long vol as option traders say, delta hedging a single option is not always a perfect approach. As soon as the stock price changes, your sensitivity to further changes in volatility is altered because of gamma. In theory, the returns associated with delta hedging an option are fixed and are entirely based on the difference between the implied volatility of the option when it was purchased or sold and the realized volatility of the underlying over the life of the option. In the real world, with discrete rather than continuous delta hedging, which means that traders occasionally rehedge rather than constantly rehedging at every second throughout the life of the option, this turns out not to be the case. Variance and volatility swaps were created to allow investors to hedge volatility risk or to speculate on implied volatility in a clean manner without the need for continuous delta hedging, which can be both expensive and inefficient. The naming of these products as swaps is somewhat misleading, as they're more like forwards. This is because their payoff occurs at maturity, whereas swaps have intermediate payouts over the life of the contract. So, what are volatility swaps? A volatility swap is an over-the-counter financial derivative which allows investors to trade future realized volatility against current implied volatility. It acts like a forward contract on the future realized volatility of a given underlying asset. Volatility swaps allow investors to trade the volatility of an asset directly, much as they would trade a stock or an index. At inception of the trade, the strike is usually chosen such that the fair value of the swap is zero. The volatility notional is the notional amount paid or received per volatility point, or per 1% shift in realized standard deviation. The payout of a volatility swap is the notional multiplied by the difference between the realized volatility and the volatility strike agreed at inception. The profit and loss on a volatility swap relates only to the realized volatility of the underlying and is unaffected by any directional moves. Thus, it gives you a simpler and more pure volatility exposure than delta hedging an option does. So, how do we replicate and hedge volatility swaps? Well, there's no simple replication strategy for a volatility swap. Variance rather than the volatility exposure is what you get from hedged options trading. From a derivatives point of view, variance can be viewed as the primary underlying, and volatility swaps are best regarded as derivative securities on variance. Volatility, being the square root of variance, is a nonlinear function and is therefore more difficult both theoretically and practically to value and hedge. The main difficulty with pricing and hedging volatility swaps is that they require a volatility of volatility, or vol of vol model, and if this model is not representative of the real world, your pricing will be wrong. Volatility swaps are very difficult to hedge, and so market participants moved towards trading variance swaps, as variance swaps can be statically replicated. Volatility swaps cannot be hedged by a static portfolio of options, but they can be hedged with variance swaps. For small moves, the payouts of volatility and variance swaps can be similar. On screen right now, you can see the payoff of a volatility swap and a variance swap as a function of realized volatility. For more on this topic, take a look at the textbook for this course. A link to it is in the description below. Hopefully you found the video helpful. If so, click the like button and click the subscribe button if you'd like to see more videos like this. Tomorrow's video will be on the topic of variance swaps. See you then and have a great day. Bye.